الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد, the author he mentioned رحمه الله تعالى باب ما جاء في النشرة, باب ما جاء في النشرة, the chapter with regards to that which has come about النشرة, meaning about the clarification and the details of this affair, the affair of النشرة. النشرة, it means to cure the individual who has been afflicted with magic, and the one who has magic put upon him, it will be removed in this manner by النشرة, by النشرة. And we've seen in the previous chapters, the author, he mentioned, rahimahullah ta'ala, the clarification of the rulings of magic and that which is related to that, and that this word is sihr, means sorcery and magic, and that the origin with this affair is that it is performed by seeking aid from the devils and the shayateen, and by casting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala behind the back and degrading it, and by obeying the shayateen and worshipping others besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order for the magic to take effect. And likewise, we have seen that there are other issues as well that this word sihr has been used with regards to. And some of these affairs are lesser than that, and they do not all have the same ruling. And each one is according to its reality and the type of magic and sihr that is performed by way of seeking aid from the devils and the shayateen and the obedience of the devils and the likes, and by degrading the Quran. And this is major disbelief, and this is shirk. And as for that which is lesser than that, then it takes the ruling specific to that affair. And this has proceeded, alhamdulillah. And likewise, the author, he mentioned after that another chapter that is related. And that is the chapter about the Kuhan and the fortune tellers and the Arrafun and the Rammalun, and those people who claim to have knowledge of the unseen. And now he's mentioning this affair, rahimahullah ta'ala, about Nushra and about curing and removing the magic. And it's very clear the relationship between this and the chapters with regards to magic and sorcery, with regards to a sihr. But as for the relationship of this chapter with regards to the previous chapter about the fortune tellers and those who claim to have knowledge of the unseen, then likewise there is a suitable relationship. And that is, many times individuals who have magic performed on them, many times individuals who have magic performed on them, they will go to the Kuhan and to the Arrafin, and they will try to find out who was the one who put the magic on them. Or they will try to ask them where the magic is so they can destroy it, and the likes like this. These people who claim to know the unseen and claim to know where the missing objects and the items are and the likes like this. And we have seen the ruling of that likewise. And we have seen the ruling of that likewise, and that this is not permissible to go to them. And the one who goes to them and believes in what they say, believing that they know the unseen, then this is disbelief. Then this is disbelief. So therefore, it's very suitable now after these two chapters, the chapters with regards to a sihr, and the chapter with regards to al-kuhan, and those who are similar to them, from those who claim to have knowledge of the unseen, now to discuss the issue of al-nushra. The issue of al-nushra. The people of knowledge, they mention al-nushra to halu sihr. عن المسحوري ومن يظن به المس. يعني this means to remove the magic and to cure the individual who has been afflicted with magic, or likewise to try to cure the individual who has been touched by a jinn, or one is thought, or it is thought that he has been touched by a jinn. So to do this, curing the one who has magic placed upon him, or he's afflicted by magic and the likes like this, or the one who was afflicted by the jinn, to cure him and to remove that magic and the likes like this is called a nushra, and this is nushra. This is called a nushra, and this means to cure the sick and to bring him back to his normal state. And this word, it comes from nashara, and it means to come to life. It has many meanings, but from them, it is to come to life. And like you say nashara. And you say nashara and anshara. And this has come in the Quran like this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned, ثُمَّ أَمَاتَهُ فَأَقَبَرَ, speaking about the human being, that he will cause him to die and put him in the grave. ثُمَّ إِذَا شَاءَ أَنْشَرَ, and then whenever he wills, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَنْشَرَهُ أَيْ أَحْيَاهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهِ, meaning he will bring him back to life. أَنْشَرَهُ أَيْ, he will bring him back to life. And from this aspect, likewise, we have the issue of al-ba'ath wal-nushur. Al-ba'athu wal-nushur. The ba'ath is the resurrection, and nushur is coming back to life after death, is the life after the death. And likewise, Allah referred to those disbelievers who deny the life after death and coming back to life for the and the resurrection. And they say, إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا مَوْتَتُنَا الْأُولَى إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا مَوْتَتُنَا الْأُولَى وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمُنْشَرِينَ. In verity, it is only our first death, and we will not be brought back to life. And we will not be brought back to life. So this word, it comes from nushra comes from a nashr, which means to come back to life. And here what is intended is that the person, he will come back to his normal state after being sick. That he will come back to his normal state after being sick. So from this aspect, it's called a nushra, to bring the sick person and the one who is sick back to his normal state of health and the likes like this. This is called an-nushra. But the issue with an-nushra is that in the time of Jahiliyyah and the likes, it was known amongst the Arabs that this word was used, an-nushra, to refer to curing magic with magic, specifically. That it was used to refer to curing magic with magic, and specifically. And we will see that there is more than one type of nushra. And there is a type that is haram and impermissible. And this is to cure the magic with magic, similar to it. And the one who performs this is the magician himself. So this aspect here, this is haram and not permissible. But as for the other aspect of a nushra and curing the one who is afflicted with magic by the recitation of the Quran and the legislated and allowed and permissible ruqa and the types of ruqya and the likes like this, and likewise the permissible and halal and the mubah medications that are allowed to treat sicknesses and the likes like this, all of this is permissible and this is allowed, and this is what the author is going to clarify in this chapter. So he mentioned, rahimahullah ta'ala, the narration of Jabir, and he says, عن جابر رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سئل عن النشرة فقال هي من عمل الشيطان رواه أحمد بسند جيد وأبو داود. The author, he mentioned the narration of Jabir رضي الله عنه, Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari, and he said that the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was asked about النشرة, he was asked about النشرة, curing the one who was afflicted with magic. But here, as has preceded, what is referred to here is a nushra, al-ma'rufa, in that time, the well-known nushra. And this is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he responded with his response. And he says, hiya min amal ash-shaytan. And nushra is from the deeds of shaytan. It's from the action and the work of the devil. It's from the action and the work of the devil. So here the people of knowledge, they clarify that what is being asked about here is a nushra al-ma'huda al-ma'rufa fil jahiliyyah. It is the well-known nushra that was known and understood in those days. And that was to seek to cure the one who has magic placed upon him with magic that is similar to it. With magic that is similar to it. So therefore, from this aspect, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, hiya min amal ash-shaytan. Hiya min amal ash-shaytan. It's from the work of the devil. And this is because it has preceded that magic can only occur and take effect by seeking aid with the devils, by seeking aid in the shayateen, and they're the ones who help him to perform his magic. So the magic, it is from the work of shaitan. And the nushra here is to cure that magic with magic like it. So therefore, likewise, it is from the deed and from the work of shaitan and from the devil. So therefore, it is haram and impermissible and has the same ruling, because likewise, it is magic. It is magic. So therefore, to seek to cure magic with magic that is similar to it, then this is also impermissible and haram and has the same ruling as magic in the first place. Magic in any aspect, the type of magic that one applies it by seeking aid and assistance and seeking nearness to the shayateen and to the devils, then this is all major disbelief. then this is all major disbelief. The author, he says, رواه أحمد بسند جيد. Imam Ahmad, he narrated this with a good chain. Ahmad ibn Hanbal, رحمه الله تعالى, he died in the year 241. And likewise Abu Dawood. And likewise Abu Dawood, Abu Dawood al-Sijistani, صاحب السنن, Sunan Abi Dawood, رحمه الله تعالى, Sulaiman ibn Ashath, he died in the year 275, رحمه الله عليه. After this, the author, he mentioned another narration. He says, وَقَالَ سُئِلَ أَحْمَدُ عَنْهَا فَقَالَ إِبْنُ مَسْعُودٍ يَكْرَهُ هَذَا كُلَّهُ. And likewise, the author, he mentioned that Imam Ahmad, he was asked about Anushra. He was asked about Anushra. Again, the Nushra here that is referred to is the one that is known in the time of al-Jahiliyyah, and that is the type of Nushra and curing the sick with magic, and curing the one who is afflicted with magic that is similar to it, with magic, and curing the sick with magic. So he says here that Ahmad, he mentioned that Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu is yakharahu hadha kullahu, and that verily Ibn Mas'ud, he disliked that all of it. He disliked that all of it. And what it means here by disliking that all of it, meaning that it is haram. And with regards to the early generation of the Salaf, they used to use the word karaha to refer to a tahrim, and that which is haram and impermissible. As for in the later generations, then many of the people of knowledge, they would differentiate between these terms. If they use karaha, they would use it to refer to something that is disliked and it's not impermissible. Karaha to tanzih. And they would separate between that and between at-tahrim. But as for the early generation of the Salaf, they used to refer to at-tahrim with the word karaha. So this is a benefit that if we see this word al-karaha, or yakrahu kada, or akrahuhu, and this is coming from the early generation of the Salaf, many times what is being referred to here is that it is haram. That it's haram. The makruh here does not mean dislike, but rather it means that it is impermissible. And that is what is being referred to here in the statement or in the position of Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abu Abdurrahman al-Hudhari radiallahu anhu. He died in the year 32 after the hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Kana yakrahu hadha kullahu. He disliked that all of it, meaning he found it to be haram and impermissible. Radiallahu anhu. After this, the author, he mentions, rahimahullahu ta'ala, wa fi al-Bukhari. عن قتادة قلت لابن المسيب رجل به طب أو يؤخر عن امرأته أيحل عنه أو ينشر قال لا بأس به إنما يريدون به الإصلاح فأما ما ينفع فلم ينهى عنه انتهى. Here we see the author, now he mentions a narration that is found in Sahih Bukhari, and it's a narration that is mu'allaq, meaning that the chain is not connected. But it has been connected in other books of hadith, and it is authentic chain on Qatada. Qatada ibn Di'ama al-Sudusi. Qatada ibn Di'ama al-Sudusi, rahimahullahu ta'ala, he's from the Tabi'een, from the students of Anas. He was born blind, rahimahullahu ta'ala, but he was a great scholar and reciter of the Quran, and he had great fiqh and understanding, and he was known for memorization and strength in memorization and steadfastness in the deen. Qatada ibn Di'ama al-Sadusi, rahimahullahu ta'ala, he died in the year 117. He says, I said to Ibn al-Musayyib, and this is Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib, rahimahullahu ta'ala, likewise from the Tabi'een. He died in the year 94, 95. In this manner, also from the greatest of the Tabi'een, and the most knowledgeable and well-grounded in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He asked him, he said to him, رَجُلٌ بِهِ طِبْ, a man that has been afflicted by طِبْ, أَوْ يُؤَخَّرُ عَنْ إِمْرَأَتِهِ, or he is not able to go to his wife, or he, any meaning that he dislikes and he turned away from his wife. أَيُحَلُّ عَنْهُ أَوْ يُنَشَّرْ, can he be cured any with the nushra? And Ibn al-Musayyib, rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, لَا بَأْسَ بِهِ, there's no problem with that. There's no problem with that. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُونَ بِهِ الْإِصْلَاحِ The people who are trying to cure him, they're only trying to rectify and fix the affair. فَأَمَّا مَا يَنْفَعُ فَلَمْ يُنْهَ عَنْهُ As for that which is beneficial, then it was not prohibited. As for that which is beneficial, then it was not prohibited. The author, he says, إِنْتَهَ This is the end of that which is mentioned in al-Bukhari. So we see here, he says, رَجُلٌ بِهِ طِبَّ رَجُلٌ بِهِ طِبَّ And طِبَّ means medication. But what is intended here is a sihr. And sometimes we'll find in the Arabic language, it will come like this, that they will replace a bad word with a good word, having optimism and good hopes that a person will be cured. Like the one that is ladigh. Ladigh is the one who has been stung and bit by a poisonous animal. They call him Salim. Salim means that he's safe and sound and cured, healthy. And they call him Salim, and كيف السليم, يعني كيف اللذيغ, يعني the one who has been bit and poisoned or stung by the poisoned animal, they call him Salim, yani having optimism and good hope that he will be cured. So like this, the one who has magic on him, they will call him the one who that has طب on him. He has magic on him, meaning they say that he has طب on him, but yani really he what they mean is that he has magic on him. But they say طب referring to medication, yani with hopes that the person he will be cured. In this manner, having a tafa'ul. أو يؤخر عن امرأته, or he is turned away from his wife. And this is known as a sarf, and it's a type of magic likewise, a sarfu wal atfu, and some types of magic could be used to bring people together, and other types of magic could be used to separate from people. So if a person, he has طب, meaning that there's magic placed on him, or if he has been turned away from his wife, Qatada, he is mentioning that he asked Ibn al-Musayyib رحمهم الله تعالى أيحل عنه أو ينشر can we cure him and use the nushra to cure him قال لا بأس به there's no problem with that and he said that what they intended by that is just to rectify and as for that which is beneficial then it was not prohibited so here what is being referred to here is the permissible type of nushra and this is with ruqya that is legislated from the recitation of the Quran and from trust and reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and returning to him sincerity with dua and trust and sincere faith and hope for his reward and for his aid and his help and for his cure subhanahu wa ta'ala and trust and reliance in that manner with recitation of the Quran and likewise with recitation of adhkar that are legislated and as well as taking the allowed medication that has been proven to be beneficial in these circumstances and the likes like this. All of this is permissible and all of this is good and this is a type of nushra and curing the one who has been afflicted with magic or with a jinn and the likes like this in a manner that is permissible and this is what Ibn al-Musayyib is referring to here. Rahimahullahu ta'ala. And then after this, the author, he says, وَرُوِيَ عَنِ الْحَسَنِ أَنَّهُ قَالَ And it has been narrated from Al-Hasan that he said, لَا يَحُلُّ السِّحْرَ إِلَّا سَاحِرٌ That no one cures the magic except for a magician. That no one can cure and remove the magic or the sorcery except for a sahir, the magician or the sorcerer. And this is a narration from Al-Hasan, Al-Hasan al-Basri. Rahimahullahu ta'ala, also from the Tabi'in, he died in the year 110, and also from the greatest of the Tabi'in, Rahimahullahu ta'ala. He says, لا يحل سحر إلا ساحر. That no one can cure the magic except for a magician, or the sorcery except for a sorcerer. And this is in reference to curing the magic in the manner by seeking aid and the devils and the shayateen and the manner that is well known in the times of Jahiliyyah and in those days. And nobody cures the magic in this manner except for a magician. Nobody cures the magic or can remove the magic in this manner except for a magician. This was something that is well known. And this is something that the people should be aware of. That going to the magician and using magic and the likes like this, even if it is to remove magic, then this has the same ruling. It has the same ruling. And being pleased with magic is disbelief. And using magic is disbelief. And the likes like this. So this is something that is very dangerous. This is something that is very dangerous, to try to cure magic with magic, and to go to the magicians and ask them for magic, and to perform magic and the likes like this, or to go to the fortune tellers and to those who claim to have knowledge of the unseen, and to ask them to find out the individuals who perform the magic, and to be pleased with that, and to be pleased with the fact that they seek aid and assistance in the shayateen and in the devils and the likes like that. This is all not permissible. This is all dangerous and a foul in a bad way. The author, he closes the chapter now with a beautiful statement of Al-Imam Ibn Qayyim, rahimahullahu ta'ala. And he mentions here the statement, he says, An-Nushratu, halu sihri anil mashur. That An-Nushra, it is to cure the magic from the one who has been afflicted by it. Wahuwa naw'ani, and it is two types. It is two types. Halun bi sihrin mithlihi. وهو الذي من عمل الشيطان وعليه يحمل قول الحسن فيتقرب الناشر والمنتشر إلى الشيطان بما يحب فيبطل عمله عن المسحور. He said رحمه الله تعالى that Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah رحمه الله تعالى, from the great scholars of the Sunnah, he died in the year 751. He says that Nushra is to cure the magic from the one who, to remove the magic from the one who is afflicted by it. And it is two types. The first type is to cure or to remove the magic with magic that is like it and similar to it. To remove the magic with magic that is similar to it. And this is from the work of Shaitan. This type of Nushra here is from the work of the devil, وَلِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. And this is what is understood in the statement of Hassan that has preceded, that لَا يُحُلُّ السِّحْرَ إِلَّا سَاحِرٌ. No one removes the magic except for the magician. And this is what is intended here, by removing the magic with magic that is similar to it. So he clarifies here how they perform that. فَيَتَخَرَّبُ النَّاشِرُ وَالْمُنْتَشِرُ فَيَتَخَرَّبُ النَّاشِرُ وَالْمُنْتَشِرُ إِلَى الشَّيْطَانِ. So the one who is performing the magic and performing the nushra, and likewise the one who is being performed to, both of them will seek nearness to the devils. They will draw near to the devil in a manner that the devil likes and he wants. And at this time, after the one performing the nushra and the one whom the nushra is being performed for, and the nushra that is muharrama, whenever after they both seek nearness to the shayateen by obeying him and doing that which, by obeying them and doing that which they command, at this time they will remove the magic. They will remove the magic from the one who was afflicted. And in the shayateen, they will do that. When will they do that? After an-nashir wal-muntashir yatakharrabani ilayhim. After the one who is the magician who is performing the nushra, and after the one whom the nushra is being performed for, seek nearness to them, bima yuhibbun, in a manner that they love and that they like. And it is known that the shayateen, they do not like anything except for kufr and shirk. Waliyadu billah. Waliyadu billah. So this is what is being referred to here in the hadith. And likewise, in the narration of Ibn Mas'ud, and also in the narration of Hassan, this type of nushra here, that is curing the magic with magic, and by going to the magicians to work magic, to remove the magic. And this is haram and impermissible. And this is haram and impermissible. And this is likewise considered a disbelief. وَلِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. He says, Rahimahullah, وَثَانِي النُّشْرَةُ بِالرُّقْيَةِ وَالتَّعُوذَاتِ وَالدَّعَوَاتِ وَالْأَدْوِيَةِ الْمُبَاحَةِ فَهَذَا جَائِزٌ. And then Ibn Qayyim, Rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions the second type of an-nushra is with ruqya. وَالتَّعُوذَاتِ, ruqya, by the ruqya, by reciting the Qur'an, وَالتَّعُوذَاتِ, from mentioning the adhkar, ruqya, and تَعُوذَاتِ, by reciting the Qur'an, والدعوات, and mentioning the adhkar that are legislated, وأدويات المباحة, and likewise the permissible medications that are allowed, that do not have anything in them that is impermissible. They're not made from from things that are considered najis or haram or impermissible, and likewise they're not there's no seeking the aid of the devils with regards to any of these medications and like this, fahadha jaiz, he says, fahadha jaiz, this is permissible, this is permissible, so this is allowed. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned in a hadith, hadith Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu fi Sahih Bukhari, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ دَاءً إِلَّا أَنزَلَ لَهُ شِفَاءً, that Allah, he did not send down any disease or sickness, except he sent along with it the cure. Except he sent along with it the cure. Likewise, it has been collected by Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah ta'ala, from the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud, radiallahu anhu, a similar narration. يعني ما أنزل الله داء إلا وأنزل له دواء علمه من علمه وجهله من جهله, that Allah, he did not send down any disease or sicknesses except he sent along with it the cure. Those who know it, they know it, and those who do not know it, they do not know it. So therefore, the cure is found for everything. Some people, they know them, and some people, they do not know them. And likewise, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, it's been collected by Imam Abu Dawood, fi sunanihi, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, tadawu ibadallah, wa la tadawu bil haram, that you should use medication, but do not use the medication that is impermissible. But do not use the medication that is impermissible. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, وَمَا جَعَلَ اللَّهُ الدَّوَاءَ فِيمَا حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ, and Allah did not make the cure for any disease and that which is, he has made impermissible for you. وَكَمَا قَالَ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So therefore, there are legislative and proper cures for these affairs, for the affairs of those who have been touched with magic, نَسَأَلَ اللَّهَ الْعَافِيَ وَالسَّلَامَ, and those who have been touched by the jinn and the likes like this, that there is a proper means and a legislated means to seek a cure and a nushra that is allowed and mubaha and permissible. And this is by putting trust and reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely, and putting one's faith on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with devotion and sincerity, and calling on Him alone and hoping in Him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala, and begging Him to cure the individual in this manner. And then likewise reciting the Quran with strong and firm faith and hope and trust and reliance upon Allah Azza wa Jal, and also the legislative athkar that have come as well, and also taking the means of medication that are effective for the particular issue and the likes like this, then all of this is allowed and all of this is permissible and all of this is good. And as for going to the magicians to work magic in order to remove the magic, then this is haram and impermissible, and this is not allowed. After this, the author, he closed the chapter. He says, وَفِيهِ مَسَائِنَ فِيهِ مَسَائِنَ, this chapter, it has some issues and benefits. الْأُولَى النَّحْيُ عَنَ النُّشْرَى, the first mas'ala is the impermissibility of a nushra, is the impermissibility of a nushra. He says, الثانية الْفَارُقُ بَيْنَ الْمَنْهِيهِ عَنْهُ وَالْمُرَخَّصِ فِيهِ مِمَّا يُزِيرُ الْإِشْكَالِ, and likewise, the second mas'ala here is the difference between the one that is impermissible and likewise the one that is allowed, and in this manner the problem is removed. And even, you know, some people, they may read these texts and think that there is some contradiction, but there's no contradiction whenever there is the proper understanding and clarity comes from the understanding of the Salaf. Walillahi alhamd. So therefore, again, to close this issue, the nushra is two types. And the first type is that which is known in the time of Jahiliyyah, that which the people were upon in the land of the Arab in the days of Jahiliyyah, and that is to cure the one who was afflicted with magic, or the one who was touched by the jinn with magic, by going to the magician and having him work magic in order to remove the magic, meaning he will seek nearness to the shayateen for them to remove the magic that was placed on the individual. So he will work magic to remove the magic. This is haram and impermissible. This is haram and impermissible, and this is disbelief. This is disbelief to use magic in this manner. And then after that, there's another type of cure that one can seek and use, and that is allowed and permissible and legislated to cure the one who's afflicted with magic or touched by the jinn. And this is from trust and reliance and calling on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely, and the recitation of the Quran with the intention of ruqya, and likewise the recitation of the adhkar and the supplications that have come in the sunnah, and as well taking the permissible and the halal medication that is known to benefit in these affairs. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.